Ladies and gentlemen, after all we have experienced this year, you may wonder whether it is actually worth forecasting macro and market developments into the future. We strongly believe it is, as we would like to avoid unnecessary risks where we can when investing in financial markets. Still, we are humble enough to know that some surprises will always remain. But wouldn't it be too easy otherwise? Currently, we are prepared for some nasty economic data in the winter months, particularly in those countries that have imposed strict lockdowns and severe restrictions to contain the COVID pandemic. Even though schools remain open, such that parents can go to work and restrictions are better targeted than in spring, they weigh heavily on consumer confidence and the service sector over the next few months. Warmer weather and the availability of a vaccine will change the macro picture substantially from the second quarter of 2021 and allow for a very strong rebound. The catch-up potential is enormous. Only in China, GDP exceeds its pre-pandemic level right now. In all other countries, it is lower than at the end of last year. In the case of Switzerland, 2.1%, in the US, 3.5%, and in the euro area, even 4.4%. The rebound will also be supported by extraordinary expensive fiscal and monetary policy measures that have never been as aligned as they are now. Even in countries like Germany, which in the past often had a strong preference for budget surpluses. In China, we already see how strong a rebound can be post-COVID. China drives a recovery in the manufacturing sector that is expanding even in locked-down countries. Demand for manufactured goods is also the reason why international trade is as strong as it is right now. All this, however, has had no influence on inflation rates yet. They remain depressed, as many services like package holidays, air travel, cultural and entertainment services remain in low demand at the moment. If inflation rates remain below central bank targets for too long, there is a risk that inflation expectations are becoming entrenched at undesirably low level. Therefore, the Fed has made clear that it is not going to raise policy rates prematurely in this cycle. Instead, the Fed will allow inflation to overshoot its 2% target for a while, in order to make up for the period during which it was too low. This may take a few years, during which inflation rates and expectations are increasing steadily, but slowly. Throughout this period, central banks will continue their bond purchases in order to contain the upward pressure on yields. As a result, real bond yields will remain low, while the recovering economy should lead to somewhat higher nominal yields and steeper yield curves. For risky assets, and in particular for equity markets, low real yields and a recovering economy is a wonderful combination. It allows earnings to grow healthily while keeping valuations elevated. Therefore, we are optimistic for equities for the next 2 years and note that earnings expectations are already pointing upwards again. Emerging market equities should do best next year with gains of 14%, as they should benefit from a further weakening of the US dollar. Developed market equities are set to deliver a more moderate 9%, led by equities in the UK. We like UK equities tactically, as their returns are largely a function of low valuations and the rebound potential for various sectors that have been hit hard this year. Structurally, we continue to prefer US equities, which should resume their outperformance once a cyclical value rebound is complete. And what about FX? If the business cycle picks up, as expected from the second quarter of next year and into 2022, cyclical currencies such as the euro and the Canadian dollar should do well, while the US dollar should weaken further. And relatively favorable real interest rates will benefit the Japanese yen and the Swiss franc. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm also looking forward to all those things that we do not know yet about 2021. But I think it would be fair to enjoy a year with, on balance, more positive surprises for a change. Thank you for your interest. I wish you all the best for your investments next year. Stay safe and healthy, and have a pleasant day.